Okay guys, so continue tayo dito sa Oriface. So this time, solve natin yung problem na to. A composite non-prismatic 5 meter high na cylindrical tank as shown in the figure has the form of a prostomoba cone at the bottom with 2.5 meter diameter uppermost and 1.25 meter diameter at the bottom and 4 meter high. Okay. So the bottom contains 100 millimeter diameter na Oriface. So bali ito is... So, bali ito. So, ito is 100 millimeter diameter na orifice. So, with coefficient of discharge of 0.6, so, determine the time to empty yung composite tank in minutes. Okay, so para ma-solve natin 'to, kailangan muna natin ma-solve isa-isa, no? Yung ano, yung problem. So first nating gagawin is kukunin yung time to remove yung volume nung water dito sa cylindrical tank. And then kukunin natin yung time required to discharge yung volume of water dito naman sa prostomoba cone. So then i-add natin yan sila lahat. Just to solve yung total time to empty the tank, okay? So, bali. So, to find the total time to empty the tank is meron tayong T1 plus T2. Where yung T1 natin is yung time to remove the volume of water of cylindrical tank only, while yung T2 yan naman yung time to remove the volume of water of the prostom only. Okay, so unahin ko muna computein yung time to remove the volume of water of a cylindrical tank. Okay. So, calculation of T1. So, makikita natin dito sa figure. Na ganito, no? Kopyahin ko muna 'to. And then, lagay ko yan dito. So, ito yung initial condition natin. So, bali, yung gagawin natin is ganito na bali magiging itsura. Ito yung initial condition. And then in the final condition is gaganito siya. Okay, so bali matanggal yung water dito sa cylindrical tank. So, yung may iiwan is yung volume ng water dito sa frustum. So, bali, yung magiging edge 1, kasi yung edge natin is always dito sa center ng orifice, patungo dito sa free water surface. So, yung edge 1 natin is... meters yung ito. Then dito yung orifice, so yung magiging edge 2 natin is itong height na to, which is 4 meters. So ito naman yung sa final, so ito naman yung sa final, condition. So may formula tayo, no, na pag cylindrical yung tank, so for cylindrical tank, so pwede natin gamitin yung formula diretso na 2 area ng cross sectional area square root ng initial height minus final height all over coefficient of discharge area ng orifice square root ng 2 times the gravity. So kunin ko muna yung T1. So I have 2 times pi over 4. So nakikita natin dito na yung area ng cross section, considering yung cylindrical tank is pi over 4, 2.5 squared. So we have pi over 4, 2.5 squared. And then we have square root nung H1, which is 9. And then yung HF natin, or yung final orifice, is itong 4 meters. All over, coefficient of discharge that is given, we have 0.6. And then pi over 4, we have diameter ng orifice that is also given. We have 100 mm. So, that is 0.1 meter, no? 0.1 squared. And then, we have square root nung. Yung unit is naka-meters. Meters, meters, meters. So, gawin ko is yung 9.81 meters per second. So, meron na tayong value nung T1. Okay, so, computein muna natin. Okay, so bali dito meron tayong 2, then shift pi over 4, and then we have a 2.5 squared, and then we have square root of 9 minus square root of 4, and then we have 0.6 ng pi over 4 ng 0.1 squared. And then, square root ng 2 times 9.81. So, therefore, we have 470.34 seconds. So, 470.34 seconds. So, next is yung T2, yung time to remove the volume of water in the Proust thermal pump. So, calculation of T2. Okay, so, consider naman natin yung sa prostom. So, bali dito, meron tayong ganyan. Say, ito na lang yung 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And say, 1, 2. Siyempre na lang naita, no? Okay, so for this tawag niyan, would say, tanggalin ka na lang. Okay, so bali yung gagawin lang natin dito is calculus. So kuha tayo ng differential strip sa dito. So let's say ito yung differential strip natin. And this one is gawin ko na lang dh. So bali yung height na yan is h from dito. So bali ito is yung diameter niya is 2.5. So 2.5 divided by 2, so we have 1.25. And then dito naman is meron tayong 1.25 divided by 2, so therefore we have 0.625. Okay, so assume ko na lang na x yung dito. So ayan dito, so x yan, x din yan, kasi dito then is also 1.25. So this one, this is 0.625. Okay, so bali considering yan, considering no, ito, ito bali yung gitna niya. Then ito alam natin, this is 0.625. And then dito alam natin, this is 1.25. So i-project ko yan. So this one is ilan yan? That is 0.625. So this one is 0.625. Tsaka yung ito is also 0.625. So bali considering yung x, so assume ko na lang na dito yung x na yan. So ito yung full length na x. And then ito yung 0.625. So ibig sabihin yung natira dito is x minus 0.625. So pwede natin i-consider yung triangle na to para makakuha tayo ng equation by Bayesian proportion. So bali, meron tayong ito yung total height niya pala is 4 meter yung given sa figure. Yung ito. So we have 4 meter. So bali dito is meron din tayong 4 meter. So this one is 4 meter. So by Bayesian proportion, bali ito yung consider ko. So 0.625 all over yung total height na to. That is 4. So kunin natin to. So we have this one, this is x minus 0.625 all over yung height naman to, which is h, di ba? So this one is h, yung dimension na to. So we have now the value of h. Okay, so yung h in terms of x is just yung x na lang din. So yung h, that is x 4 times x minus 0.625 all over 0.625. And okay, so kung kukunin natin yung x in terms of h, so meron tayong 0.625 h, and then meron tayong 4x minus 0.625. So bali, divide ko na lang to ng 4 lahat na. So 0.625 divided by 4, that is 0.15625H, and then I have x minus 0.625. So bali dito makuha natin yung x, no? So yung x is just ano, wala yung edge. So yung x natin is just 0.15625h plus 0.625. So babalikan natin yung formula for flow rate, that is just volume over time. So para ma-analyze to, kailangan natin ng differential volume and differential time. So, which is equivalent to coefficient of discharge EO square root of 2GH. So, yung time natin is just equal to differential volume over coefficient of discharge area ng orifice square root ng 2GH. So, integrate lang natin to. Integrate lang natin to from 0 to time. And then, dito is yung H initial to H final. Okay, so bali magiging ano to? H initial to H final. So we have area ng section DH all over CD EO square root nung 2G square root nung H. So meron na tayong integration from 0 to T. And then we have H initial to H final ES DH. Ilagay ko na yung H. So yung H raised to power of negative 1/2 ng DH all over CDEO square root of 2G na. So bali ngayon, kasi kung di ba dito sa ano, continuous kasi ito. So ito na yung final condition nung natanggal na yung water dito sa cylindrical tank. So bali ito na yung magiging initial condition dito naman sa prostom, yung kailangan natin ma-remove na lahat. So bali ito yung initial condition niya ngayon. Okay, so ito na yung magiging initial condition niya. And then yung magiging final condition niya, initial condition. And then yung final condition is ito na bali. Bali matatanggal na lahat ng water. So, yung initial condition niya will be 4 meters. And then, yung final condition niya is 0. So, bali dito, magiging ano to? So, T na tayo. Tanggalin ko na yung derivative na yan. Integration from 0 to 4. ES H to the negative 1/2 DH CDEO square root of 2G. So ito na yung gagamitin natin sa calculation. Okay, so yung magiging ES natin dito is itong area nung differential strip na to. So yung ito. So kukunin natin yan, ha? So yung ES. So where yung ES natin is just pi x squared. So meron tayong pi. And then yung x natin is ito yan. So kukopyahin ko na lang yan. And then lagay ko na lang yan dito. So this one is squared. So meron na tayong ES, we have pi, so 0.15625 squared, that is 0.0244 h squared plus 2 times 0.15625 times 0.625, so we have 0.1953125 h plus 0.625 squared, so meron na tayong 0.390625. Okay, so ito na yung full equation natin for ES. So substitute natin yan dito. So we have now integration from 0 to 4. So we have pi ng 0.0244 h squared plus 0.1953125 h plus 0.390625, and then meron tayong h to the negative 1/2 dh all over cd natin is 0.6, and then we have pi over 4 ng 0.10 squared. So ito na yung area ng orifice, and we have 2 times 9.81. So thus meron na tayong kumpitin ko na lang, palabas ko yung pi, ilan yung ilan yung shift pi all over 0.6 ng shift pi over 4 ng 0.1 squared times square root ng 2 times 9.81. So we have 150.51. So okay na yan na. So we have 150.51 integration na ng 0 to 4. And then multiply ko na yung h na. So I have 0.0244. So 2 minus 0.5, so that is 3 halves. Okay. So h and the 3 halves plus 0.1953125 h to the 1/2 plus 0.390625 h to the negative 1/2, then ito lahat is naka dh. Okay, so continue tayo. So integrate ko na to. So integrate ko na to. So meron na akong t. That is 150.51. Then integration ng 0.244. So plus 1 tayo, no? H 5 halves all over 5 halves. So times ko na lang to ng to. So divided by 2 yan. So akyat ko na yung 2. Plus 0.1953125 h, so that is 3 halves, so divided by 3, akyat ko na yung 2 diretsa, and then plus 0.390625 h to the 1/2, so divided by 1/2, so 1, akyat ko na yung 2, and then ito is 0 to 4. So, therefore, yung kinocompute natin dito is T2 lahat, ha? So, we're computing for T2. T2 and T2. So, therefore, meron na tayong value ng T2. So, substitute na lang natin yung value. So, meron na tayong 150.51 2PIF ng 0.0244 times 4 to the 5 hubs plus 2/3 ng 0.1953125 times 4 to the 3 hubs plus 0.390625 times 2 times 4 to the 1/2. So yung T2 natin is just equal to 438.96 seconds. So meron na tayong value ng T1 tsaka T2. Ito na yung T1, and then ito na yung T2. So masolve na natin yung total time. So T1 lang plus T2. So I have 470.34 plus 438.96 seconds. So therefore this is 909.30 seconds yung T2 total to empty the tank. So we have 470.34 plus 438.96, so 909.3 divided by 60, so we have 15.16 minutes, kasi yung gusto nyo makuha is in minutes. So that's it, no? So ito na yung total time. To empty the tank. Okay, so that ends for an orifice. So sa next na video is magpunta na tayo sa wires. Okay, so see you in the next video. Thank you.